Hi, good evening. I am absolutely delighted to be here in this wonderful place playing a program for the Guimarães International Guitar Festival. Thank you for joining us. I'm going to start with a piece written by the Spanish composer and guitarist Fernando Sor. I like it very much. Because it's very joyful and it's very fresh, spontaneous, probably because it was based in a couple of French popular songs. It's his Fantasy number 7. It starts with a set of variations on a children's song and continues with an allegretto in sonata form. So, Fantasy number 7 by Fernando Sor. Thank you. Next piece that I will be playing, or next pieces, because it's a couple of movements that I have taken from Manuel de Falla's ballet, El Amor Brujo. They are very short. The first one is more evocative. It's named Escena, Scene. And the second one is more rhythmical. It's his Canción del Fuego Fato, the Magic Fires song. The character of these pieces is connected with the plot of the ballet, which is full of midnight magic rituals, mystery, and dances with ghosts. Thank you. piece that I will be playing now is called Capriccio Diabolico, written by Mario Castelnuovo Tedesco as a tribute to Niccolo Paganini, the devil's violinist. Mario Castelnuovo Tedesco dedicated this piece to the Spanish guitarist Andrés Segovia. And I believe that he was very much inspired both in Paganini's virtuosism as well as in Andrés Segovia's poetic aesthetics and elegant magical phrasing. There is a manuscript, but I'm going to play Andrés Segovia version, which finishes with an allusion to Paganini's La Campanella, which in turn was inspired in an Italian folk song. Thank you. The last piece that I will play in is called El Silencio que Mata, The Silence That Kills. The composer is Agustín Castilla Ávila. It's a quite recent piece. It was composed in March this year. And this is quite dramatic because it's a tribute to women victims of oppression. The composer is inspired in the similarities between the shape of the guitar and the feminine silhouette, and compares the sounds produced in the instrument with the sounds that we produce with our voice. And the whole piece presents a fight between normal sounds produced as traditionally and some other not so natural sounds, more artificial sounds, such as, for example, sounds when plucking in the other part of the string, or percussions, or pizzicatos, tambora, harmonics. These sounds represent this oppression, this lack of freedom. The rhythm is especially important here because it represents the heartbeat that sometimes speeds up, sometimes slows down, sometimes there is no rhythm at all. Silence. And the very end is especially dramatic because I finish with both hands like here, grabbing the neck of the guitar. Again, very symbolic, like representing this oppression and lack of freedom. So, El Silencio que Mata, The Silence That Kills, written by Agustín Castilla Ávila.
Thank you.
This piece is much more kind, joyful. The composer was Roland Diens, and the piece is called Omaggio to Heitor Villa-Lobos. It is divided into four movements, and is very much inspired in the Brazilian rhythms as well as in a few of Heitor Villa-Lobos' compositions. And finally, because we celebrate Piazzolla's anniversary, I would like to play a couple of his five pieces for classical guitar, Accentuado and Compadre.
Thank you.
Thank you for listening to my concert. Thank you again to the Guimarães International Guitar Festival. And goodbye.